Looks like a beautiful day outside. The perfect weather for a promotion. My alarm clock. I tell you, that thing is loud! It scares Gary half to death. It's an ice cube. It's kind of shaped like me. It's a spatula. Quite useful for flipping Krabby Patties. It's my special toothbrush, made for only two teeth. Needed to jimmy it. White shirt, brown shorts, red tie. Classic. My clothes! I need them. I'm bashful in the nude. Let me disconnect this wire to this thingy. There, that wasn't so hard.
Mr. Manager, sir?
Say, Patrick, tonight after my big promotion, let's go out and party till we're purple.
I love being purple.
Why are you watching a TV that isn't even on?
My remote stopped working.
You could just get up and turn it on.
There's no need to overreact.
Patrick, that's my remote. No wonder it doesn't turn your TV on.
So, you say this is your remote?
Yes.
Then what is it doing at my house?
That's what I love about you, Patrick. You always ask the really important questions.
Exactly.
So, can I have my remote back?
Then I'm gonna have to get up to turn on the TV and go to the kitchen to get more ice for my Kelpsy. Why? 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 This cruelty is unbearable!
Well, what if I got you some ice for your Kelpsy? Then you'd only have to get up once.
You'd do that for me?
No problem, buddy. Getting ice is what friends are for. Except in France. Here you are, buddy. One piece of ice. Hurry up and take it. It's melting.
Oh, now wait just a minute. This ice is cold.
Yeah?
You don't fool me for one second, mister.
Okay.
I'll let you off easy this time, seeing as you probably have other things on your mind. But don't let it happen again.
Okay, I won't.
Here's your remote.
Thanks. That must be Squidward's new phone number. He sure changes it a lot. I should give him a call sometime. Squidward. What you doing?
I'm composing the next movement of my latest opus. The theme is unwelcome visits from neighbors. Right, what you know?
Opus, huh?
What do you want, SpongeBob? I'm sort of busy here.
How can you compose a porpoise with the radio on?
Opus and the radio give me, ideas. I mean, inspiration. I don't steal my melodies, if that's what you're saying.
Maybe I'll turn the radio off for you. Would you like that? I'd do anything to help.
Honestly, SpongeBob, I couldn't care less what you do. As long as you do it as far away from here as possible.
Well, bye for now, Squidward.
Oh, you're leaving? My horoscope was right. Today is a day of great joy.
Ah, much better. Now Squidward won't be so deaf to the rest of the world. There! Now I can hear myself think!
Hello? Who is it? Who's there? Is this you, SpongeBob?
Listening to the sound of the ocean all day.
Hello? Who is it?
I don't even think Squidward has teeth. He won't miss this. Aha! That did it! Hooray! My teeth are clean. Now I can go to the Krusty Krab to accept the mantle of manager. I'm ready. Responsibility.
Looks like a beautiful day outside. Perfect weather for implementing an evil scheme. Let's see what we can come up with, shall we? Down here!
What do you want?
I need to find a way to steal Mr. Krabs' secret Krabby Patty recipe. I've tried everything I can think of.
In other words, not much.
You aren't helping.
Have you checked all the evil plans in your filing cabinet?
Yes, every last one, from A to Y. There is nothing left.
What about Z?
Z?
Z, the letter after Y?
Oops!
Oh, boy.
That is all for now, wife. Return to your spousal duties at once.
By spousal duties, do you mean overlooking your many faults and watching you blunder your way through another doomed attempt to take over the world?
I have one word for you. Magnet.
You couldn't lift it.
It's a symbol of the oppression of the working class. Also, it's a wrench. You think that mop looks too big for me to carry? Shows what you know. Now let's see, plan C, yeah. Steel crown, frame crabs, I like it, it's got panache. So let's do this step by step. Step one, get to Neptune's castle and steal his crown. Child's play. A wrench can be quite a precision tool, as long as you know exactly where to throw it. Let's test the robotic SpongeBob and see if he performs his duty. Jetpack! It's my jetpack! It allows me to fly far above the heads of those who will one day be my vassals! Jetpack doesn't handle too well. I must not have tightened the phalanges sufficiently. Let's hope I don't get into an accident. Ah, Neptune's castle. Why don't I have a castle, you may very well ask? Sadly, that question lacks a satisfactory answer. Anyway, let's get down to business. It's a stinky seahorse shoe. Seahorses don't even have feet. What genius thought of these? You wouldn't need a battering ram to break these down. A battering worm would do just fine. It might be a thread to some, but to me it is a coil of the strongest rope. Aha! It's a stinky seahorse shoe with a thread tied to it. Genius, I tell you! Over matter once again. Each victory is sweeter than the last. Aha! Once again, my genius silences the pundits. The crown is mine! Mr. Krabs, prepare to meet thy doom!
I better get to the Pattymobile, quick! That's the only way I'll be able to reach Shell City in time to save Mr. Krabs! Hey there, Squidward. I just wanted to say congratulations on the promotion.
A lot of good it does me with Mr. Krabs frozen. Who's gonna sign my new and improved paychecks?
To show that there are no hard feelings, I'd be more than happy to sign your paychecks.
SpongeBob, you really are a Knucklehead-McSpazatron.
So I need to get to Shell City quickly. I'm gonna use Mr. Krabs' Pattymobile to get there. What do you think about that?
I think all pedestrians should be put on high alert.
Me too! Do you know where Mr. Krabs keeps the Pattymobile?
It's in an underground cavern beneath the restaurant. You can get to it through the kitchen, but you need a pass card to use the elevator.
Barnacles, where can I get one?
Well, as manager, I was issued a pass card just today.
Woo! Can I have it?
No, you can't.
But I need it!
I lost it, okay? I was cleaning a table, and it must have fallen out of my pocket. There were a couple of kids in here earlier, a boy and a girl. I bet one of them took it.
Barnacles.
Don't tell Mr. Krabs, if he ever gets unfrozen, that is.
Well, goodbye, Manager Squidward. I have to go save Mr. Krabs now.
Ha! Yes, well, good luck. I'm sure you can't possibly fail.
Hey, you're right! Thanks, Squidward! Little girl.
Hi.
Hey, have you seen a card with little holes punched in it lying around?
Oh, you mean the super powerful magic plastic thingy?
Maybe. You seen it?
Yep.
Do you have it?
Nope. Morty has it.
Oh. Who's Morty?
My friend.
Do you know where he is?
He went to Goofy Goober's. He said he wanted some weird ice cream.
Thanks. What are you doing?
I'm standing.
Wow, me too.
Yep.
I'm gonna go. Have a nice day.
Bye.
Essential component of any chef's apron pockets. Well, I guess if I'm going to find Morty, I better visit Goofy Goober's. Strictly business, though.
Hello.
You like Goofy Goober, huh?
Yep.
Me too.
That's nice.
Hey, what's that thing on the table?
It's my super magic fairy card of power. I found it at the Krusty Krab.
Ooh, can I have it?
No, I found it. It's mine.
I'll be your bestest, most friendliest friend.
No thanks.
Isn't there anything I can do to get you to give me that super califragilisti-thingy?
I guess I might trade it for some fried ice cream.
Fried ice cream? Ugh.
Hey, don't knock it till you've tried it.
Well, I gotta go. Important matters demand my attention. Hi!
Oh, it's you. I remember you. Did you get the carpet cleaning bill yet?
Ah, the other day. That was fun, huh? We ate some ice cream. Bye! And we were singing.
Fun? I was here all night cleaning up after you. Kindly don't do it again.
One order of fried ice cream, please.
We don't make fried ice cream.
Well, what do you make?
Unfried ice cream.
All right, Skipper. One unfried ice cream cone.
Here you are. And after last night, one is your limit. And don't call me Skipper.
I'm off. Thanks, barkeep.
Hey, any day you don't throw up on the bar is a good day.
It's an ice cream cone with tongs attached to it. Brilliant! Kid, one fried ice cream cone.
Hooray! Crunchy and creamy! Gimme!
Can I have that pass card now?
Yeah, take it. Thank you.
Mr. Krab doesn't trust people enough. This is my favorite song.
Hello, Mr. Manager, sir.
Nothing can stop us now, Patrick. Feel the wind in your hair. That's the taste of freedom in your mouth.
I thought it was a bug.
Hi! Nice day, don't you think?
Yep.
So, how's life on the Bikini Bottom Frontier?
Tougher than you can handle. Ain't that right, Lloyd?
These guys are getting on my nerves.
So, what have you fellas been up to?
Not much. It's enough fun just watching poor saps like yourself try and survive over the county line.
Oh, but we did go to Goofy Goober's last night. That was fun.
Shh. Why'd you have to go and tell them that?
Well, you looked like you were having fun, singing and dancing on the tables, and then you...
I did not.
Yes, you did, and you hugged Goofy Goober and told him he was your best friend, and then I got upset because I thought I was your best friend, and then...
Pay no attention to him.
And then you got the sheet music to the Goofy Goober thing. Because you said you wanted to go home and learn to play it on your harmonica.
I don't even have a harmonica. I really have no idea what he's talking about.
Oh, yeah? Well, then why don't you empty your pockets? You're still wearing the same pants. I bet the sheet music is still in there.
Don't be ridiculous. Excuse me for a moment.
He even said that Goofy Goober was his hero, and that he wanted to be just like him.
Where did he go?
Okay, I'm back. No sheet music in my pockets. I have no idea what you're talking about. And I think we should stop talking about it right now.
Did you just throw away the sheet music?
I am never speaking to you again.
I'm off!
You ain't gonna last 10 seconds over the county line.
Oh yeah? We'll see about that. It's sheet music for the Goofy Goober song. Who in their right mind would throw this away? Again?
Yep.
I found your Goofy Goober sheet music in the trash in there.
I'm afraid you are mistaken. Please go away.
I'm off!
You ain't gonna last 10 seconds over the county line.
Oh yeah? We'll see about that. Our car! We have to figure out a way to get it back. The guy who took it probably has the keys near him.
Let's just march in there and take them.
Patrick, I think we're gonna have to be a little more sneaky than that. Maybe if we distract him.
Yeah, distract him.
Then we can take the keys while he isn't looking.
Sounds like a great idea.
Okay, let's get to it, buddy.
I gotta go to the bathroom.
But Patrick, what about the distraction? Barnacles! Hi there, mister! I mean, misters.
Hello.
What are you two doing?
We're drinking rusty dirt water and trying to remember the words to a song.
Oh, yeah? What song is that?
That's none of your business.
Is it the Goofy Goober song?
Yes. No, I mean, maybe. Why, you know it?
I know most of it. Want me to teach it to you?
No, if someone hears, we'll get in trouble.
Maybe I can find another way to show it to you.
You do that. We're not going anywhere.
Here you go, fellas. The sheet music to the Goofy Goober theme song. Enjoy.
Shh. You have to say that so loud. Thanks.
There's no soap in the thing. Barkeep, nice place you've got here.
No, it isn't. It's a nasty place, and we'd like to keep it that way.
Ah, well, you know best.
What do you want? In case you didn't notice, I'm in a bad mood.
Say, the soap dispenser in the bathroom is out of soap. My hands are kind of dirty. You think you could refill it?
You're lucky I don't refill you. To the brim with a pipe and hot butt whooping. Fine. It'll get you off my back.
Well, squeeze me dry and call me Gerald. It worked!
There, bud. Hope you're happy. Actually, I hope you're miserable. So forget I said anything.
May I please have some ice cream?
Ice cream? Only babies eat ice cream. You're not a baby, are you?
No. I mean, no.
I'm not so sure about that myself. Watch your step or you'll end up squashed. We deal with babies in a most unpleasant way.
I'm gonna look around your beautiful establishment if you don't mind.
Ooh, bust out the red carpet for Mr. Fancy Talk. Boy, I oughta. Hey, who blew these bubbles?
Quick, Patrick, let's grab the keys while he isn't looking.
Good idea.
I have to find a way out of here. Maybe I can commandeer Daddy's seahorse carriage. It's very fast, and I need to get to SpongeBob and Patrick as quickly as possible. That's where I keep my clothes. Well, my shirts anyway. The one downer about being a mermaid is that I miss out on all the great shoe sales. Wow! This mirror is filthy. It's embarrassing. It's a bottle of glue. Ah, that lets the mirror in. Better not close that window now, or it'll get stuck shut. Out of my way! I need to get out of here to help my friends!
I'm sorry, Princess Mindy. I was specifically instructed by the king not to let you leave until he returns.
You don't understand. If you don't let me out of here, someone could die. My father has a bit of a temper.
I know. That's exactly why I'm not letting you out of my sight. I don't want to end up in that dungeon like that poor crown polisher.
He threw the crown polisher in the dungeon?
Yeah, he said, "Now that I don't have a crown, what do I need you for?" Why don't you go polish some bars? And poof, to the dungeon he went. I ain't going out like that.
Doesn't that sort of injustice make you mad?
It's all relative. I mean to say, it could have been worse. Could have been me. Could still be me if you follow me.
That is the wrong point of view, if you ask me.
It's a point of view that's kept me out of jail so far.
You realize that blindly obeying orders without thinking is a dangerous thing to do?
Not as dangerous as blindly disobeying orders.
Okay, I know you aren't going to believe this, but a major sea monster is outside my window, and he said something about your mother.
My mother? Out of my way! For king and country and mommy! Well, this is embarrassing. I seem to be stuck. Mindy! Little help here! Mindy! I think I've been had.
That took care of him. Now I need to get to Daddy Seahorse carriage. He keeps it just outside the courtyard. Hello, faithful guard. Any news to report?
I stubbed my toe. Twice today. Same toe both times.
Wow. So you stubbed your toe, huh? Nothing else to report?
Twice. The same toe. I thought it really hurt the first time, but you know what? The second time made the first time seem like a mermaid shiatsu.
I have to go.
Same toe. Both times. Imagine the luck.
Hello, faithful guard. Any news to report?
Not much going on today. My buddy over there stubbed his toe twice. He won't stop moaning about it.
Pretty dull day, huh?
Except for the toe stubbing, yeah.
I have to go.
Imagine if he sprained his ankle. We'd never hear the end of it.
Dungeon Master's Handbook. And it's got a picture of a dragon on it. Hi.
Hello, Princess.
Wow. It smells so much better down here now than it did last week. The stench level is almost tolerable.
Yep. The guards have stopped passing out and everything.
What was it?
You're probably better off not knowing. Let's just say, mold can crop up in the most unexpected and surprising places.
I can't believe Daddy threw the crown polisher in the dungeon after all.
Yeah, he was very upset. He had me put him in the worst cell. It has bad lighting, and its chi is all out of whack. I couldn't spend 5 minutes in there without losing it.
When is he getting out?
Well, your father said, never, not in a million billion years. I will see him rot for an eternity, and another dozen eternities on top of that.
So?
Tuesday, probably.
Can I see the crown polisher, please?
Sorry, Princess. I can't let you by. The king wouldn't approve.
I just want to talk to him.
Nope. I can't let you. Sorry.
How goes the dungeon running business?
Oh, it's thriving. There's always someone to question. More throw into a cell or shackle. I just wish I was better at it.
Don't be so hard on yourself. I think you run this dungeon just fine.
Well, you know, they don't teach you this at school. If I had a book on it, I could do so much better.
A book on running a dungeon, huh?
Yeah. It could tell me what to do. Like, should I use the rack? Should I glower menacingly? Or give an evil laugh? Stuff like that.
Sounds like it would be an interesting read. Look what I brought you.
The Dungeon Master's Handbook. Wow! Thanks, Mindy. You're the greatest!
Do you think I could get in to see the crown polisher now?
Okay, okay. But just for a minute. And don't tell anyone I let you go back there. The first thing it says in this here book is never show your soft side.
I promise, I'll tell everyone how scary and intimidating you are.
Thanks, princess.
Oh, dear. Daddy really did throw you in the dungeon. Poor little fella.
Hi, princess.
I can't believe Daddy went behind my back and threw you in here, after promising me he wouldn't. I'm going to have a few words with him.
No, please don't. I know you mean well, but I think it just upsets him more. Really, I'm okay here for a while.
How are you passing the time in here?
I count rats. It takes longer than you might think. I do miss my old job, though. Oh, what I wouldn't give for something to polish.
Say, can you polish this mirror up for me?
Really? Can I? It's been so long since I've polished something, I'm starting to go into withdrawal.
Here you go.
Thanks. There you are. Polished as good as new.
Thanks, little fella. Hi. Any idea where Daddy went?
Mindy, shouldn't you be in your room? I thought I heard the king say you were grounded.
I was grounded, but then Daddy called and said that I was free to go.
Oh, that old softy.
Yeah, freeing your own daughter from imprisonment. He's quite the teddy bear. Why are you still here? Shouldn't you be away with Daddy?
I should, but I asked permission to stay here because I, want to, go see Dolly.
Dolly? The ranch hand? Wait a second. Do you like her?
Maybe, but I'm too afraid to talk to her.
Don't be afraid. Just go tell her how you feel. Any girl would be lucky to have you as an admirer.
Do you really think so?
Yeah. Now don't waste another minute. Go tell her how you feel.
Okay, I will. But wait.
What's wrong?
I need to check how I look. I need a mirror. Do you have one I can borrow?
I do have one somewhere. Here's my mirror.
Ah, okay, magnifique. How could I have doubted my own suavity? Thank you, princess. And now I must go. I have a date with destiny.
Good luck.
With eyes like mine, luck isn't necessary.
Wow, that was a quick 180. SpongeBob and Patrick in no time!
We have to cross this plane to get to the other side of the trench. It looks pretty spooky, but I know we can do it.
We just passed a hotel. Can't we stay there for a while?
No, Patrick. We have to get to Shell City. We don't have much time left.
Hello there!
nice place you got here.
It is indeed. Oh, indeed it is.
Isn't this sort of an odd place for such a swank hotel?
What can I tell you? Speculative real estate is a risky business. And I got this place for a song. The land was an old oyster bed. Nobody would touch it.
I demand room service. 2 Krabby Patties to my room immediately.
You don't have a room.
Well then, I demand mouth service. 2 Krabby Patties to my mouth immediately.
How about lip service? I think I could accommodate your gracious and noble personage there, sir.
Are you insulting me? Because if you are, you do it better than anyone I've ever met.
If that is truth, then my life was not in vain.
Well, nice talking to you.
Your suavity, your elegant way with words, I shan't soon forget you.
Wow, your room is so much bigger than mine. Well, bigger than I imagine mine would be, if I had one.
I'm guessing you usually knock before coming into a person's room?
Nah, don't see much point. Nice room, huh?
I'm of the opinion that it has a vaguely larcenous motif.
You can say that again, and I still won't understand it. Are you all right, ma'am? You seem upset.
No, I'm not all right, as a matter of fact. Somebody stole my pearls last night from right out of this very room. And whomever it was left this strange orb in its place. I'm in a state of shock.
Pearls, huh? Patrick, what do you think?
I think it's a job for Detective SpongeBob and Inspector Star.
Me too. Never fear, madam. We have never lost a case or even taken on a case. In either case, we have a perfect record. To be brief. Case.
Oh, dear.
We will investigate this matter fully. Search every nook and cranny for clues, just in case. Be all over this place like a cheap suit. Case.
I don't know what to say.
Inspector Star, we must keep our eyes peeled. Give everything a long, hard look. If people think we're rude, so be it. If staring will solve this crime, then we shall stare. Case.
Staircase.
May we ask you some questions about the incident?
I suppose so.
When was the last time you saw your pearls?
Last night. I'm not sure what time, but they were on the table next to the lantern. I don't know how someone could have gotten in here without me hearing them.
Was your door locked last night?
Yes. I lock it when I go to sleep. I leave it unlocked otherwise, assuming people will be courteous enough to knock before barging in. Apparently, I was wrong on that count.
Thanks. Well, nice talking to you.
Yes, a pleasant mindless break for me as well.
Those are strange holes. They look like wood rot, but it's too dark to see down them. If only I had more light.
SpongeBob?
Yes, Patrick?
I think I'm gonna stay out here.
Why?
I'm afraid of caves.
But you live under a rock.
And?
Well, I mean, a cave, a rock.
Are you saying my house is like a cave?
Well, not really. Slightly cave-ish, maybe.
I'm gonna pretend like I didn't hear that.
Okay, have it your way. Wait here, I won't be long. Are you lost?
Hardly. One cannot be lost when one is at home. I am Charles Oscar William Piedmont Augustus Winthorpe. and the world is my backyard. From the Marianas Trench to the Great Barrier Reef, wherever I go, home follows.
Are you a superhero?
No, I am an explorer.
Pretty long introduction for someone who's not a superhero. Did you know your initials are Cowpaw?
Yes, it is a fact that the baser intellect never fails to point out.
And people say I have a silly name.
Do they? How interesting.
What is this cave?
This is the entrance to the Crustacean Caverns, an ancient set of caves that protect the focusing orb.
Orb, huh?
Yes.
Neat.
It's more than neat. The focusing orb points out safe passage through the abyssal plains. They're quite impossible to cross without consulting it.
Ooh, the abyssal plains! That's where we need to go!
Well, in that case, you'll need to get past the corridors of confusion.
Corridors of confusion, huh?
Yes, and beyond them, you must consult the pool of perception. And then finally, the doors of deception.
Did you make up these names?
Possibly, but I assure you, they are most descriptive.
Can you possibly lend me your flashlight?
Well, I suppose you can borrow it. Now don't break it. It is precious.
Gimme!
Use it well.
Tell me about the corridors of confusion.
They are a series of passages. Each one glows a different color. And in order to pass them, you must enter them in the order that they light up.
Sounds kind of silly.
Yeah, it is kind of silly now that you mention it, but it's the only way to get to the pool of perception.
Tell me about the pool of perception.
It's a pool deep in the heart of the cavern that, legend has it, tells you your future when you gaze into it.
I can tell you your future if you like. I see years of therapy.
Hey, I didn't make up the legend.
Tell me about the doors of deception.
I don't know much about them. I have not as yet had the privilege of studying their legends. I'm sure they're quite dangerous.
Good luck with your expedition. I've gotta go.
Yes, off with you.
I thought that guy said there'd be lights in here.
Welcome to the confounding corridors of Crustacean Caverns. Follow the lights, or you will surely be lost.
Whoa! Easy on the reverb there, Ringo.
Enter each corridor in the order it lights up. A mistake will lead you back to the beginning. Only through concentration can you hope to make it to the inner sanctum of the Crustacean Caverns.
Okay. Guess I'd better pay attention.
Is,
but I'm pretty sure I've got more of it than some old fogey.
Who can argue with that logic?
Say, nice swimming pool.
That is not a swimming pool. That is the pool of perception. Looking into its depths gives you a vision of your own future.
Is it heated?
No.
Well then, call it whatever you like. I call it lame.
Charming.
So, the future, huh?
Yes, but you must be careful. Each time you look into the pool, you look further and further into your own future. That can be dangerous.
Dangerous, huh?
Yes. Knowing your own future can destroy an individual's sense of free will.
Free will, huh?
Yes. The temptation to contradict what you see as your own future can cause a person to do drastic things.
Drastic, huh?
You aren't understanding anything I'm saying, are you?
Understanding, huh?
Forget it.
Say, you wouldn't by any chance know a way to cross the abyssal plains, would you?
Actually, I do. The inner sanctum lies beyond the doors here. In it is a device that uses sunlight to illuminate a path through the fog of the abyssal plains.
Great! I am so there!
I cannot let you in. The focusing orb has been stolen. Those doors must remain locked until the orb has returned.
Focusing orb?
Yes, it aims and intensifies the light. The inner sanctum does not function without it. It would be of no use to you.
Who stole it?
I don't know. Nobody can get to the inner sanctum without passing by me, and nobody did. But if you can find it, I will allow you passage beyond these doors.
Well, nice talking to you.
Personally, the conversation has renewed my interest in taking a vow of silence.
Like there's another room under here. I wonder how I can get there. Maybe the manager knows. Hi, it's me again.
Oh, the sheer luck with which I've been graced. Someone fanned me, I may think.
Do you know one of your tenants had some pearls stolen from her?
Yes, Victoria Ellen in room one. How could I not know? She has made quite a stink about it.
Well, well, well. We have come to a conclusion from our investigation.
Pray tell, I'm all ears. Can't wait to hear it.
There is something living under the hotel that comes in through holes in the floors of your rooms. I think this creature may have taken Mrs. Ellen's pearls.
No, can't be. I knew something like this might happen.
Something like what?
Well, when I bought the land for this hotel, there was an old oyster bed here. I didn't think it would make a difference, but maybe, just maybe.
Oysters, huh? May I have permission to check under the hotel?
Oh yes, this is all my fault. Check, check.
Well, nice talking to you.
Your suavity. Your elegant way with words, I shan't soon forget you.
These look like Mrs. Ellen's string of pearls. The little guy must have thought they were his. I better return them to her. Hello again, elderly person.
Hello again, slightly annoying and yet oddly endearing person.
May I have the orb that the thief left behind?
Certainly not. I'm not letting this thing out of my sight until I get my pearls back.
Barnacles, here are your pearls, Mrs. Ellen.
Oh, thank you so very much, young man. These were a gift from my darling first husband, Edward. They mean so much to me.
Ask her about the reward! Ask her about the reward!
Patrick, that isn't very polite.
Oh, sorry. Please ask her about the reward! Please ask her about the reward!
Well, you boys certainly deserve a reward. Here, take this orb. I don't need it now that I have my pearls back.
Respectful.
Look, I got the focusing orb. Go me, go me.
Ah, excellent. I will open the doors for you. Beyond them, you will face another puzzle before getting to the inner sanctum. Once you have passed it, place the orb on the pedestal. Then the fog.
Great! Thank you, oh Ancient One.
I'm 52.
Wow! And I thought only Coral lived that long. This looks familiar.
Welcome to the Confounding Corridors of Crustacean Caverns, Part 2, The Revenge.
Part 1 was way better.
Follow the lights, or you will surely be lost.
Here we go again. Door was the right one. Wow, it's like magic without the rabbit. Ooh, the light cuts through the fog. We should follow it. Thank you. We gotta push on, Patrick. We're making good time.
My feet hurt.
Mine too. We can't let it get to us, though. We're men.
Hey, maybe we should go see that guy.
In pain? Come see Dr. Louie. He'll make you guys feel better.
I'm in pain!
I don't know, Patrick. Doctors are scary!
Maybe he has lollipops.
You make a good point. Hi there, big fella.
You want something? No?
You are quite possibly the largest starfish I've ever seen.
Yes, it is in my genes.
That those genes have a size 46 waist. Bye. A little denim humor.
Don't push it.
Do you know what's going on here?
Of course I do. I am a soldier in the Revolutionary Army. I fight for all invertebrates everywhere. Well, when I say fight, I mean stage protest. But it is every bit as noble.
If you guys are protesters, shouldn't you have signs and be chanting slogans and stuff?
That's what I said. But our leader Octavio said, it's better we just stand around outside this here place looking mean.
And you know, you do that very well. Okay, I'm gonna go.
Viva la revolution!
Hi! What's going on, guys?
We are protesting on their treatment at the hands of the chiropractic overlords.
What's a chiropractic?
A chiropractor is a doctor who treats the back and spine. And we are not going to take the injustice they deal any longer.
Oh, I don't have a spine. I'm a sponge. So I guess I can't join you guys.
You are speaking the nonsense. We are all invertebrates at this rally. None of us have spines.
Oh, well then what good is a chiropractor?
You are missing the point. We are protesting the right to see this chiropractic charlatan. None of us actually want to see him. We just want the right to do so.
Patrick, this sounds like a job for two men.
Squidward and Mr. Krabs?
No.
Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy?
Nope.
I give up!
You and me, Patrick! It is our duty as men to help these people iron out their differences.
Oh! You just reminded me of something really important.
What's that?
I think I left the iron on at home.
So we have decided to help you come to an agreement. Take me to your leader.
Ha ha! Marius, get a load of the yellow one. He wants to see Octavio.
As if anyone off the streets can demand to see Octavio.
Octavio?
Yes. He is the generalissimo of the invertebrates. And he does not see just anybody. He is a busy man. He does not have time to chit-chat with the riffraff.
Does he have time to fiddle-faddle with the flim-flam?
Do not ask him about his personal business.
So what would I need to do to get to see Octavio?
Well, I would need proof that you are serious about helping our cause. If you could bring a peace offering from the despicable Dr. Louie, then I think we could do business.
I'm on it! Okay, I'm gonna go.
Viva la revolution!
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Hi, can I help you?
I'm here to see the doctor.
That's nice. Do you have an appointment?
Not as such.
Well, he's a pretty busy guy. Let me see what I can do. What's your name?
SpongeBob SquarePants.
No, seriously.
SpongeBob SquarePants.
Do your parents not like you?
They love me. Why?
Just curious. Anyway, what species are you?
I'm a sponge.
A sponge, huh? Well, I'm sorry, Mr. SquarePants, but Dr. Louie is a chiropractor.
Yep.
Well, a chiropractor deals with bones. The backbone, or spine.
Uh-huh.
Well, how can I put this? You are an invertebrate.
Yep.
So, you have no spine. No bones. How can you be treated by a back doctor if you have no back?
Very carefully?
No, I'm sorry. Unless you have a spine, you cannot see Dr. Louie.
Barnacles! Are you aware that there's a protest going on outside the office?
I guess, if you can call two people a protest.
They're upset that the doctor won't treat them.
It's not that he won't treat them. It's that he can't treat them. Are you even listening to me at all? They have no bones.
It's not nice to tell someone they have no bones.
It's a tough world, little guy.
Isn't there any way I can see Dr. Louie?
Yeah, there is a way. Get a spine. Then I'll pencil you in.
Good day to you, ma'am.
Bye.
That sea urchin won't miss one little spine. He's got hundreds. Hi, it's me again.
I could tell, because my heart went all a flutter.
So, guess who has a spine?
Not you. You're a sponge.
Wrong-o. What is this?
It's a sea urchin spine.
Exactly. So let me in. I'm gonna see the doctor.
You have missed the point entirely.
Patrick, did not this kind lady say earlier that if I got a spine, I could see Dr. Louie?
She did! I heard her!
And I do believe this is a spine. Ergo, therefore, and thusly, you should honor your word.
I don't get paid enough for this. Fine. Give me a moment.
Patrick, we are quite possibly the smartest creatures living under the sea.
Did you see her? She was all confused. It must be hard being so stupid. Whoa, wait a minute. We live under the sea.
Okay, you can see Dr. Louie now.
Hooray! Hiya, Doc.
Hello. What seems to be the problem?
So, the word on the street is that you're from Egypt and you lack motivation.
Excuse me?
Yep, I know all about it. You're a chiro slacker.
Chiropractor.
Tomato, tomato, let's not mince words.
I'm a chiropractor and you're a sponge. You have no bones, so I really can't help you. I'm not sure why Whitney let you in here.
You aren't sure, huh? Well, I've got news for you. Your flunkies have failed you. You're all alone. Your kingdom is crumbling at your feet.
You seem rather excitable. Perhaps I should prescribe a sedative.
I'll say. I'm here to talk about the protest you have going on outside.
Oh, that. Yeah, those guys are kind of getting on my nerves. But the big one, he scares me. Always looking at me kind of shifty and stuff.
Why won't you treat them?
Hey, I'd be happy to treat them if that's what they want. Wouldn't help them, of course, being that they're boneless. But I'll do what I can. The problem is, they're pretty touchy, especially the leader.
I spoke with a member of the revolution, and he said that if I could bring him a peace offering, he'd help me reach Octavio.
Really? That's good news.
Got anything I can bring him?
You can take my stethoscope. You think that'll do?
Maybe. Thanks. It's me again.
Mon Dieu, don't scare me with your infectious happiness.
I got a peace offering from the doctor.
This will do just fine, I believe. I will tell you the password to get past Octavio's personal guard, but it will not be enough. You will need to wear the outfit of La Revolution. Talk to my friend Marius. He has an extra one.
Okay. What's the password?
The password is sticks and stones can't break our bones cause we don't have any.
More like a passphrase, really.
Whatever.
Mm,
SpongeBob?
Yes, Patrick?
I think I'm gonna stay out here.
Okay, have it your way. Wait here, I won't be long. Hi! Did you grow since we last talked?
You bought me.
Your friend over there said that you had an extra black turtleneck that I could wear.
I do. You can have it, but I'm afraid it won't fit.
Thanks. Okay, I'm gonna go.
Viva la revolution!
SpongeBob?
Yes, Patrick?
I think I'm gonna stay out here.
Okay, have it your way. Wait here, I won't be long. Shopkeeper?
Hey.
Take me to the leader. I have the password and the uniform.
What's the password?
Sticks and stones can't break our bones because we don't have any.
Correct. Viva la revolution. Octavio is down the ladder in the back.
Thanks. Octavio, we finally meet.
Apparently.
You are a hard man to get in to see.
Octavio must protect himself. There are people who would see Octavio hurt. You are not one of those people who would betray Octavio, are you?
No! SpongeBob would never betray Octavio! SpongeBob swears!
Octavio believes you.
So, Octavio, tell me about yourself.
If the movement were a living being, Octavio would be the brain. Jack and Marius would be the lungs, and Valcho upstairs would be the heart.
And who would be the skeleton?
No one. We would need no skeleton. Bones are like crutches, and we have no use for crutches.
I like this room. You know why?
Because to rage against the dying light stirs your soul to its core. Because a mighty beast lies dormant within your heart. And Octavio awakens that beast within the smell of injustice. A smell no cologne can cover, not even one that cost $5.
Well, I was just gonna say because it has a ladder, and ladders are fun!
Octavio weeps for the Jews.
Hey, your answer was good too. SpongeBob comes with a peace offering from Dr. Louie. He wants to offer you his services. Right now, he's trapped in his office. He's afraid Marius is going to step on him.
He just might. So you are telling me Dr. Louie is prepared to treat invertebrates?
Yes, and he gave me this stethoscope to give to you as a sign of peace.
A stethoscope, huh?
Yeah?
Dr. Louie offers his noble adversary Octavio a stethoscope?
Well...
This is momentous. This is like a warrior offering up his trident. Perhaps Octavio misjudged Dr. Louie. I must set up a meeting with this man at once.
You!
And you, Jellobone, Octavio offers his heartfelt thanks. Without you, who knows what madness we might have descended into.
Hey, SpongeBob is more than happy to help.
1,000 thanks. I will go meet this great healer at once. Viva la revolution.
Where are we?
Kansas?
I don't think so. But wherever we are, we better stay. Whoa! It's the Cyclops!
Maybe he wants to be friends with us.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Tell me about it.
This doesn't look too good, Patrick.
You mean we're not gonna get the crab? Save the time. Mr. Krabs.
I don't think we're even gonna be able to save ourselves, buddy. I guess what everyone said about us is true, Patrick.
You mean that we're attractive?
No, that we're just kids. A couple of kids in way over their heads. We were doomed from the start. I mean, look at us. We didn't even come close to the crown. We let everybody down. We failed.
Shell City.
Yep. We never made it to Shell City.
Shell City.
Exactly, buddy. That's the place we never got to.
Shell City.
Okay, now you're starting to bum me out, Patrick.
No, look at the sign. Shell City. Marine Gifts and Sundry!
Shell City's a gift shop? But if this is Shell City, then where's the... Dad? We did make it.
SpongeBob, buddy! Don't die! We've come so close! I've gotta find a way to bring SpongeBob back to life! He needs water, and fast! Making me tear up a bit. There you go, little buddy. Let my tears give you life. SpongeBob! SpongeBob, you're alive! Oh, hooray! Hooray! I'm so happy!
Patrick?
Yes, SpongeBob?
Could you stop crying all over me now?
Oh, sure, buddy.
Whoa! What's going on?
It's raining!
Your tears shorted out the heating lamp and set off the sprinklers! Now's our chance to get out of here!
In this weather?
Let's go!
I always knew it paid to be a crybaby.
We made it, Patrick. Now we just need to find a way to get back to Bikini Bottom.
Well, don't worry, SpongeBob. We can ride the...
Ride the what now?
A mythical beast with a chest of iron and some hair, too. And he roams the beaches looking for people in trouble. We just have to find the whistle.
The whistle?
Yeah, the call of the... It's a chrome whistle, and when you blow it, he comes and saves you. Hooray!
Sounds kind of crazy.
It is! Hooray!
I guess we don't have much choice. Okay, Patrick, let's find that whistle and ride that...
Hooray!
Hi there. What you doing?
I'm searching for buried treasure. You'd be surprised at how much stuff people lose at the beach.
No, I wouldn't. Found anything?
Yeah, I spotted something a little ways over there. I marked it with an X. It's nothing valuable. My metal detector says it's made of chrome. I can't be bothered with anything that isn't gold.
Gold, huh?
Yep, gold is where it's at, my man.
I'll take your word for it. If you don't want that chrome thing, can I have it?
Sure. All you have to do is dig it up. I marked where I saw it with an X.
Thanks! What are you doing out of water?
What are you doing out of water?
I asked you first.
I'm a mud skipper. I can go for days out of water. Can you?
Nope.
Well then?
Well then indeed. I'm gonna go.
Happy hunting.
It's a shell. It's kind of shovel-shaped. My home! It's a piece of driftwood. Seems pretty strong. That isn't going to work. We're back, Patrick, and just in time. Now all we have to do is give Neptune back his crown. Come on!
I think I'm going to stay here. That's Perch Perkins over there, you know? I want to interview me.
Okay. I'll be back as soon as I give Neptune his crown.
Right.
Hi, music maker.
Hey there, little dude.
Do you know I lift up my tentacle and I say tweet, tweet?
I can't say I've ever heard that one, man.
To get back to your picking.
Okay, pal. Catch you on the flip-flop.
Hello,
All hail Plankton.
Oh, barnacles on top of barnacles. Squidward, not you too.
All hail Plankton.
King Neptune, we got your crown back. Can you please let Mr. Krabs go now?
All hail Plankton.
This isn't working out like I'd hoped. Plankton, what's going on here? What have you done?
What's it look like? I've taken control of the citizens of Bikini Bottom. I've transformed them into my own personal buckethead army. They are now... Say, what's that smell?
I think I absorbed some... sweat.
Ew. Anyway, bottom line, you lose. And you know why?
Because you cheated?
No, not because I cheated. Because I'm an evil genius. And you're just a kid. A stupid kid!
I may be a kid, but I'm not gonna let you get away with this.
Listen to yourself. You even talk like a kid. I'm not gonna let you get away with this. What do you think this is? A game of kickball on the playground? You never had a chance to defeat me.
Well, I'm not giving up yet.
Good. I enjoy watching you flounder. Give it your best shot, kid.
Hi again, minstrel.
Can't escape the melodic allure, can you? Yeah.
Hi. Pretty awful what Plankton's done around here, isn't it?
Huh? What? Sorry, man. I've been so lost in a groove that I haven't noticed anything. What's going on?
He's got the whole town wearing his bucket helmet things, and they have like an antenna thingy on the top that lets him control their thoughts.
Whoa, wait a minute. Are you telling me he has sub-crypto alpha wave enhancers built into a cranial matrix?
I don't know. Am I?
Dude, this is serious, man. We have to find a way to channel the power of rock to disrupt his mind control signal.
How can we do that?
Well, we need an amplifier.
Don't you have one right there?
Yeah, but this little thing isn't gonna cut it without some modification. I need you to bring me a larger speaker.
Mr. Krabs has one in the storeroom. He was going to use it to play music throughout the Krusty Krab with subliminal messages in it, urging people to buy more stuff. Don't think the irony is lost on me.
And there's one other thing we're gonna need. A reverse polarity sub-ether frequency emitter.
You're joking.
No, we need it to tune in to the exact frequency that Plankton uses to control these buckets. It looks like a little light bulb.
Where am I gonna find one of those?
Well, Plankton has to have one, or he couldn't generate the frequency to begin with. So I guess that means...
I have to go into the belly of the beast, the chum bucket.
It won't be easy.
Nothing worth doing ever is. Never fear, I will bravely face the dangers of the chum bucket for the greater good.
Wow, you sounded like Clint Eastwood just then.
A man's gotta do what a man's gotta do. So I gotta get a reverse polar party submarine freak mitt?
Close enough. It looks like a little light bulb. And it's probably near whatever equipment Plankton is using to control these buckets.
I'll let you get back to your picking.
Okay, pal. Catch you on the flip-flop.
This will do nicely. Uh-oh, I'm not alone. Hey, that's one good-looking guy. Somehow, he doesn't look friendly. I need to get to the kitchen doors, and I'd better pick up these Krabby Patties so Plankton can use them to figure out the secret recipe. And I'd better avoid that robot knee while I'm at it. He seems upset about something. Dude will have much use for it anymore. It's an amplifier. I guess it isn't powerful enough to be of much use as it is, though. I've got to do something with these things, but that isn't it. I attach the speaker to the amplifier. But it still needs the sub-ether thingamajig to tune into Plankton's bucket frequency. I am ready to rock! It's a mega amplifier! This thing could tear the rust off a sunken ship! Now I just have to plug the guitar in and play my heart out! Say, Plankton, I've been thinking about what you said.
Yes, I'm sort of busy here.
It's just that you're right. I am just a kid.
Of course I'm right.
You know, I've been through a lot in the last 6 days, 5 minutes, 27 and a half seconds. And if I've learned anything during that time, it is that you are who you are.
That's right.
And no amount of mermaid magic or managerial promotion or some other third thing can make me any more than what I really am inside. A kid.
That's great.
But that's okay, because I did what everyone said a kid couldn't do. I made it to Shell City, and I beat the Cyclops, and I rode the... and I brought the crown back.
All right, we get the point.
So yeah, I am a kid, and I'm also a goofball, and a wingnut. And a Knucklehead-McSpazatron.
What's going on here?
But most of all, I'm...
Settle down! Settle!
I'm a Goofy Goober!
Oh, what?
Let's rock! I've got to get the notes of this song right, or it won't destroy Plankton's mind control helmets. Yeah! hit a wrong note. Wait! Wrong note.